Good.
Sorry, we're late.
And well, they'll probably be backstage set. So, we're gonna have a little longer. Yeah, we'll start, I'll start in just a couple of minutes. Yeah, I'll make some announcements and get things ready to go. So again, if you and it's a good audience to help with the move the piano in position.
Okay.
Yourself, yeah.
Okay, good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome all. So this is going to be a little bit unusual today because I have to be out in the lobby on a Zoom meeting. So some of the other faculty briefly for the first part. Come on in. Come on in, find a seat. Come down as far down as you want to come down. So the performers are going to announce themselves, introduce themselves and their selections. And so it'll just be Max Hyde-Perry on double bass, playing a few pieces, including one of his own composition and at least one is an improvisation. So I'm looking forward to that. And then Seth Kobe will sing a few selections as well. After Max performs, are there two people who are kind of down the front to just come up onto the stage and move the piano into position, okay? Can you two guys help with that? I think Max will help with that as well. And Seth can also direct you to where things need to go. So just please silence your cell phones and give the performers your full attention. I will be out in the lobby and I'll be coming in. I don't need to be in this meeting very long, I hope. I'll be around. And also the attendance, the QR code for attendance for concert class in US 120. It's on the music stand there at the top of the stairs. And I do not yet have a code for today. I have asked about a code. I have not seen it come through yet. So I will try to help. That's all that I know. So at any point, Max, you can come onto the stage.
Thank you, Dr. Bailey, for having me this opportunity. This is my final semester as a composition graduate student, and I was given the showcase some of the pieces that I was going to be opening up for my final recital next month. I'm going to be starting out with the prelude, the second Bach cello suite. And this is, of course, not a cello, it's a double bass. So it's going to be out of tune, but we're working for it, you know. So thank you very much for coming out and listening. After this, I'm going to be doing a piece by Elliot Carter, who is a contemporary composer. It was written in 2007. He uses a lot of the more modern harmonic language. And then after that, I'll be playing some semi-composed pieces, some extended technique. So, okay.
Mm-hmm.
important academic kind of composer, I think, in the 90s is when it was really kind of weird. I think the solos, I just thought it was a pretty cool piece for solo instruments, similar to Barry Oakes, an Italian composer, wrote a series of sequences for most instruments. The Figment series of Elliot Carter kind of does some similar things. So. Okay. Anyway, this last piece, this is some sketches I have. I'm calling it Kansas Looseness. It's a wordplay on Kansas firmness. So essentially, setting up kind of a B minor tonality and then trying to sidestep that into more extended techniques and getting away from notes and more into sound. It's different every time, so let's see what we have.
Thank you. today I'm going to be performing a recitative and aria from the St. Matthew Passion, and also three songs from Schubert's song cycle Winterreise. And the recitative and aria pairing from the Passion, from the St. Matthew Passion by Bach, takes place where, if you don't know, a passion is basically just a musical telling of the last week of Jesus Christ's life leading up to his death. And so obviously it's a sacred piece that has a lot of sacred themes in it. And the this aria comes in the place where Jesus Christ is forced to carry his cross on his back up to Golgotha, where he will be crucified. So in the aria, there's a lot of dotted rhythms which symbolize him stumbling around and stuff like that. And the aria is told from the perspective of an onlooker who's looking at Jesus stumbling around, trying to carry his cross, and saying, if I was there, I would have helped him carry it myself, because I love him so much. And then the second three songs that I will be doing from Winterreise. Winterreise was a song cycle that Schubert wrote late in his life, and there's a lot, you can hear from the music, it has a lot of, you know, mid-romantic themes in it. But the idea of the song cycle is it's about a person who is wandering through a winter wasteland, trying to forget the memories of his lover who left him to go be with somebody else. And the first song is called Gefrorene Tränen, and it translates to frozen tears, and it's just basically that. It's kind of juxtaposing the idea that he is in this cold wasteland so much that his tears are freezing on his face, but his heart is burning with so much heat. And it kind of like compares those two opposite ideas. And then the second song I'll be singing is called Der Lindenbaum, the Linden Tree. And it is a very, very gorgeous song, which is a conversation between the wanderer and a linden tree, specifically a tree that he fell in love with this lover under. And it is, the song is the tree calling him to come sit under it and be okay with the memories that he made and not try to run away from them. And then the third song I will be singing is called Auf dem Flusse, and it's further along in his journey when he comes by a frozen river, and he stops and he writes the name of his lover and the time where he met her and, you know, all that stuff. So it's a very gorgeous set, so yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
4, 2, 1,